Welcome to the finale of Project Erebus. I wanted to share this with you 8 months ago, but I wanted to ensure that the hundreds of hours put into the design and fabrication didn't just create something that looks exotic, but also performs well. The entire build is centered around the RTX 4090 Erebus, a unique small form factor RTX 4090 Founders Edition GPU with an all-in-one water cooling system completely contained within the GPU shroud. This modification has its own dedicated video, so check it out for more details. Two NFC SkyReach 4 tiny cases were combined into a stacked configuration to create a sandwich layout. One S4T for the GPU paired with a single HDPlex 500 watt GaN power supply, and one for the motherboard with a single HDPlex 250 watt GaN power supply. Both the power supplies are linked and receive power via a single custom sleeved cable with a GX16 aviation connector. Each chamber is isolated from the other with an aluminum divider. This prevents hot exhaust from one cooling system negatively impacting the other. The R9-7950X3D CPU is paired with 64 GB of tuned DDR5 6000 RAM and the ASRock B65 Mini ITX motherboard. All of these components, including the power supply, consume so much space that a custom water cooling system was the only efficient solution. The CPU was delidded and is cooled by a custom thermal Grizzly direct-to-die water block that has a single built-in water pump connected to a triple 50mm radiator from AlphaCool. I designed and machined this low-profile water block to work with the stock thermal Grizzly direct-die cold plate. It was cut from aluminum and acetyl and has an elite Cerakote finish. Speaking of Cerakote, the Cerakote Elite series has successfully prevented galvanic corrosion between the copper and aluminum parts used in the water cooling loops of both the 4090 Erebus and the CPU block after more than 8 months of use. This is great news because it means that we don't need to use more expensive finishes like nickel plating for water cooling systems that have a mix of aluminum and copper parts. The only major issue that I encountered was the wildly variable size of the AlphaCool radiators. I purchased three of these, and the dimensions of each one were completely different and outside the listed specifications. I solved this by cutting the top and bottom caps off and making new ones from some spare copper stock. I also added a fill port to the top cap. I wish small radiators like this had more port options. Filling and draining the water cooling loops in small form factor builds can be a nightmare. I thought about this early while making the 4090 Erebus and designed the build to have easy access to the fill ports of both water cooling loops hidden directly behind the removable front bezel. The front of the chassis has a mild steel frame that increases the strength of the linked S4Ts and has mounting points for the GPU and CPU radiator. This allows quick access to the fill ports via the magnetic front bezel. It has a 3D printed mesh insert set within an aluminum frame with polished edges. I used a 4-pin pogo connector to provide power and signal to the micro power switch and LEDs that are mounted under a genuine zinc-plated half sphere of Meteorite. It's ridiculous, I know. One of my goals for this build was to avoid modifying the S4T case parts, but it felt wrong to hide the 4090 Erebus beneath the sky slots on the cover panel. So I cut a window with a chamfered edge by 3D printing custom soft jaws to use with my CNC table vise. The 4090 Erebus features a swappable shroud design, so I made a new one to perfectly frame it within the window cutout. The rear sky IO is cut from a sheet of 2mm thick carbon fiber with plenty of ventilation holes and mounting points for the rear GPU IO. I wanted the option of upgrading the motherboard in the future without cutting another large piece of carbon fiber, so I made a universal motherboard IO cutout. This small 1.5mm thick aluminum plate will be the only piece that needs to be replaced to install a new motherboard, assuming I won't need to make a new CPU water block. A polished aluminum Skylink with the project logos crowns the build that sits upon a 12mm thick polished dark smoke acrylic vertical stand. The vertical stand has isolated channel cutouts that allow cold air intake on the GPU side and hot air exhaust on the motherboard side. A rat nest of cables can absolutely ruin a small form factor build. Cable management is something that needs to be planned well in advance. I use flexible silicone wires for builds like this and made custom length cables for all the components. The CPU radiator and fans sit within millimeters of the front edge of the motherboard. The 24-pin motherboard power cable would block airflow, so I took a radical approach and directly soldered the cables to the rear of the motherboard. The GPU and CPU have been tuned for optimal power efficiency, and the performance is the best that I've experienced with any PC under 7 liters. The 4090 Erebus core runs at a comfortable 2600 MHz with a 1000 MHz overclock on the memory while pulling less than 350 watts. The 16-core 7950X3D was undervolted to prevent thermal throttling. The AlphaCool triple 50mm radiator makes a heroic effort, but it just can't prevent the CPU from thermal throttling when running unchecked at stock settings. I reduced the voltage and limited the boost clock to 5.2 GHz. It more than meets my needs, and I'm confident that a CPU like the 9800X3D would perform very well with this cooling system. At idle and during average workloads, the sound of the system is gentle and easily ignored. However, during heavy workloads and gaming, that changes substantially. Now personally, since I usually always have my headphones on while gaming, the fan noise isn't an issue. This was one of my most challenging builds to date. It required careful planning, a lot of patience, and prototyping to make it all come together. I love the portability and its unique features that I plan to carry over into future designs. This build would have never happened if I didn't have a separate full-time career to pay for it. So if you enjoyed the video and want to support the channel, then drop a like, share, comment, or subscribe. Thank you for your time and support.